Good evening. The state television company Western Armenia represents the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast. Today is the 103rd anniversary of Sardarapat resistance. The OSCE is concerned about the incidents on the Armenian-Azerbaijani border and offers its assistance. Azerbaijan and Turkey included in USCIRF list of countries violating religious freedom and cultural heritage. Rural roads will be improved in Javakhk, Akhalkalaki. The police interfered the protest against the marble mine construction in Van. There is no democracy. There is no freedom of thought in Turkey. Orhan Pamuk, sites of Western Armenia. No festive events are planned this year, but the country's leadership will pay tribute to the memory of the heroes who resisted near the Sardarapat Memorial. The sovereignty of the Armenian people was restored in the battles of Karakilisa, Başaparan, Sardarapat on May 26, 1918. On this day 103 years ago, not far from Yerevan, the Armenian people who survived the genocide fought against the enemy for the protection of the last inch of the homeland, for the survival of the nation. The Battle of Sardarapat was decisive for the Armenian people. The whole nation stood up for the defense of the homeland. Families were on the battlefield with the soldiers, the elderly, children, women. By resisting the Turkish army in Sardarapat, the Armenian troops were able to stop the Turkish invasion of Transcaucasus and save Armenia from complete destruction. After the collapse of the Transcaucasian Democratic Federal Republic in Tbilisi on May 30, 1918, the Armenian National Council proclaimed the sovereignty of the Armenian provinces. The OSCE is concerned about the incidents on the Armenian-Azerbaijani border, the acting head of the organization, Foreign Minister of Sweden, Ann Lind, reported. All issues that need to be resolved must be resolved peacefully, through negotiations, Ann Lind wrote on Twitter. The OSCE is ready to assist and implement confidence-building measures to create an atmosphere contributing to dialogue, the statement said. Let us remind that the Azerbaijani troops are in the territory of Armenia for half a month. It has invaded in several directions and doesn't leave. Moreover, there are regular incidents. A few days ago, a fight broke out. 3 days ago, shots were fired, as a result of which an Armenian soldier was killed. Yesterday morning, the Ministry of Defense reported that Azeris had captured six servicemen of the armed forces of Armenia on the border of Gegharkunik. Azerbaijan and Turkey have been placed on a special watch list for concerns over religious freedom and cultural desecration, particularly in relation to the Armenian people, according to the United States Commission on International Religious Freedom 2021 annual report released last month, the Armenian Assembly of America informed. Mirror Spectator reports via OneLuler.am. The 108-page report recommended placing both Azerbaijan and Turkey on the USCIRF special watch list on account of egregious violations of religious freedom in both countries, including recent violations committed amid renewed conflict over Nagorno-Karabakh and surrounding territories. In the section of Azerbaijan, the report detailed findings in the context of active fighting over Nagorno-Karabakh in late September 2020 that prompt serious concerns about the preservation of Armenian places of worship and other religious sites in those areas, including the Gazancheso's Cathedral in Shushi, which was targeted and shelled by Azerbaijani forces 2 times, resulting in extensive damage to that building and possibly constituting a war crime. The report stated that the recent vandalization and destruction of Armenian cemeteries and gravestones by Azerbaijan were documented by media outlets. The Akhalkalaki municipality of Javakhk allocated 70,000 laris for the paving of rural roads in 2021, which in total is 110.2 kilometers. The works will be carried out by Ovali LSC. Private entrepreneur Mukherjee Khitaryan won the municipal tender, which was later disqualified. According to tender documents, the tender passed to the second resident. The municipality allocated 70,000 laris, Ovali LSC suggested 65,000 laris. 104.2 kilometers of road will be improved. Akhalkalaki Kartash, Akhaltskhe Akhalkalaki Akhaltskhe, Borjomi Bakuryani Akhalkalaki. The villagers protested against the marble mine to be built in the village of Yurtbash, Gyurpnar province, Van, Western Armenia. The armed police group silenced the protest action with a shot fired. 4 of the villagers who took part in the protest were arrested. Social media reached to the footage of the armed attack by the police. Officials, police and bodyguards entered the construction site in construction vehicles. After the construction equipment was brought, 40 cattle barns belonging to the villagers were demolished, where the marble mine will be opened. While residents of the district gathered to protest the incident, soldiers and bodyguards were watching the construction work. the citizens have announced that they will not allow the construction of a marble mine in their districts. They have started a protest march. Soldiers, bodyguards, and company officials left the area after the protest. New York-based Turkish writer, Nobel Prize winner Orhan Pamuk, who lives in New York, gave an interview to the Turkish Kısa Dalga news agency. He spoke about his new book, The Political Life of Turkey and His Political Views. According to Pamuk, Turkey is not democratic. Democracy in that country is just throwing belts in the box, and the boxes with unwanted results are stolen. There is no freedom of thought in Turkey. The courts and the supervisory institutions have no freedom. Even the central bank does not have autonomy, he said. He also expressed concern that Turkey is the country with the most imprisoned journalists and political prisoners in the world. Pamuk considers the lack of freedom of thought to be one of the Turkey's main problems. According to him, where there is no freedom of thought, no one can be true in the end. The historical Answer caves of Yazahan province, Malatya, Western Armenia, dating back to before Common Era 2nd century, are to be turned into tourist attractions. Walkways have been built, lighting has been provided, and other infrastructural works have been carried out for about 40 caves, which have hosted many civilizations. There is a goal to complete the work started this year. Dear compatriots, we recommend you to visit these historical caves of Western Armenia. Now I present you Armenian Philharmonic Orchestra Sardarapat. The full version is available on the official website of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.